Hey everyone, so again welcome back to my channel. So today in this video what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to make your chrysanthemum or mum, whatever you say. In Bengali we say chandramallika. So if any Bengali viewers are watching this, you may not know the name, that is chrysanthemum. That is the English name of chandramallika. So or in Bengali we say chrysanthemum, in Bengali we say chandramallika, and in Hindi it is known as guldaudi. So this plant is a very what to say, interesting plant, obviously, and one of the most beautiful and most wanted plants in India or in maximum part of the world. So in different countries where they get fall and winter, where they get snow, so that there maybe this plant is blooming now also, because this is a fall plant for them. But in our area we treat it as a winter plant, and it, in my area, it have already started to give flower buds, because during the puja, that is in the month of Kartik, or what to say, in the October, mid-October, we got a cold night where I think that plant, these plants thought that that was due to winter, but no, that was due to some low pressure depression in the Bay of Bengal where we live, near Bay of Bengal. So but we didn't get the winter yet. So now what, today is 1st November, and I'm going to tell you how to prepare your chrysanthemum plants. So I have already made a video where I have planted the chrysanthemum plants in front of you, where I have placed cuttings, because all the plants that I am going to show you today are all grown from cuttings. So they have already started to flush. You can see these are the plants that have grown from cuttings. They're looking very nice, and I can see that these two are of different colors, you can see, and they have already started to give flower buds. But now we do not need flower buds, because the time is not yet. So what we need to do is, just we need to pinch the top, just like that, this. So what this will help, in making my plants more bushier, rather it will subdivide its branches to make new branches, means from one branch it will flush two branches, and up to, means when it will reach a good height, I will also fertilize this plant later with liquid fertilizer, and I will pinch each and every plant of mine. So this one I have planted in front of you. These two I don't know what is going on, but I think this will catch up. These two got a shock, but they will catch up. So here I'm going to just pinch the tops. It will encourage new growth, it will make the plant more bushier, and I will get umbrella of flowers, which we desire in a mum plant, isn't it? So this is the, this video is up to this only. This kind of short videos I will make from now on, because I know that many of the viewers are not having time to see a long video. So this small videos I will upload, and I hope you will like this. And just drop down your comments in the comment section below if you have any question regarding this. And now after this thing, you have to definitely fertilize your plants. Fertilize with any liquid fertilizer, with whatever you have. I'm going to fertilize it with seaweed fertilizer, because right now I am not ready with the mustard cake fertilizer, because that is the best fertilizer that we give in our area. Other than this, if you are having some store-bought organic fertilizers, just go ahead and use them. There are many products organic, just you can use them. So I will obviously prefer organic things. For example, for liquid fertilizers, seaweed, zyme, and mustard cake fertilizer, compost tea, a ton of, dozen of everything is there. But for these plants, now we need growth. So we need to add nitrogen-rich fertilizers. So I think Zyme, or if you have any mustard cake fertilizer, mustard cake, you can just make that and use that in your plant. Or vermicompost, if you are having, you can just take a handful of that vermicompost, drop it down in a bucket of water, keep it for 2 to 3 days, and apply that by diluting it with some extra water. You can apply this to each and every of your plants, and I am sure you will get good amount of results in all your plants. So just like that, I'm going to pinch each and every plant of mine, and I will not fertilize today. I will fertilize tomorrow my plants, and I will show you this year my chrysanthemums, which I have already told you that I have grown from cuttings only, and I hope I will get good results. So nothing is for sure in gardening. You may get success, you may get failure. So I hope to get good results. I don't know whatever now these plants will act like, I don't know. And these are the new coleus that I have bought. I wanted to show you, and this one is the newest one that I have bought yesterday. And another plant I have bought, I'm going to show you, this is this one, Bleeding Heart. Isn't it beautiful? So I hope you like this video, and a lot of things going on. I will share with you later on this one and many other things in my garden. So okay, thanks a lot for watching. I will see you all in my next video.